Okay, good afternoon. How are you today? I hope all of you to be fine. Welcome back to MEM 330. Today lecture number 2. Last week I teach you alphabet of industrial control. Today let's go to study not alphabet, word. I say word. Because previous week I teach you symbols, standards, and also some other stuff. Today I will go on to focus on very important components, which is relays, contactors, motor starter, and control transformer. Those components, more or less, you will see it in the industry, usually, more or less. So, the goal of our lecture, number 2, first discuss the operation of different relays. I will have many types, I will show you. Especially magnetic type relay devices. Then, explain the difference between relay contactor and motor starter. A bit similar to each other, but there is a bit differences. Discuss the difference between DC and AC type relays and contactor, and describe the control transformer which is responsible to increase voltage and sometimes to adapt the voltage. Okay. Let's start with relay. I think most of you, or maybe many of you, they use already this relay. Relay is based on electromechanical movement. What I mean by that? I give electricity to the bobbin of the relay. Then what I will have? I will have on-off. Okay, what is this on-off? This mechanical movement, actually. So you can see here we have plunger, this plunger. And here inside we have wound coil. Okay? It's based on magnetic inductance. So when I give electricity here, what will happen? I will have magnet field here. Then with this magnet field, I will attract the plunger. When I attract this plunger, I will make or break, so on or off, okay? This is the principle of relays. Contactor same also, it has same principle, but let's see the difference later. So, we have two types of relay. One of their clapper. What does it mean, clapper? Do you know clap? What is clap your hand? So same, it's the clapper type. So usually when we clap our hand, we clap it in this way, right? So that way is similar. And we have bridge type. So clapper type, we have one movable contact. It means I have something, this my hand, I will not clap two together. One of them fixed and the other will be moved, okay? Will be moved this way. Second is bridge, use a movable contact to make connection between two stationary contacts. Also, I will show you the shape of both of them. Let's go for relays. This is one shape of relay. What is, when you see relay, what do you feel? Is it big, small? What kind of device when you see the relay?
Very small.
Very small, right? Okay. Actually, as you say, why it's small? Because it can only control very low voltage circuits. I don't mean very low, it means 5 volt, 3 volt. No, it can reach to 100 volt, 200 volt, okay. But if you want to control, for example, 1 kilovolt, 1 megavolt, can you use this one? No, it's impossible. This is electromechanical switches contain auxiliary contact. What I mean auxiliary? Small contact. And those are auxiliary contacts. But the meaning of auxiliary, it means small contact. Okay? And as I say, it's not suitable for high ampere or high voltage. So this is the relay. Let's go for first time, which is clapper. Clapper, as I told you, it's like clapping our hand. But here we don't move two together. I fix one and I move the other. So how I can move the other, I based on the electromechanical principle. So when I give electricity, there is some magnet field. It means I need some wounded wire. Where is my wounded wire? Here. I have this solenoid coil, you look, and I have some wounding. When I give electricity here, what will happen? Magnetic field will be induced. Then I will attract the this other hand, right? So it will be here. What will happen after electricity? It will go down. Not this way. Only from here to here. So it means it will make or break. For this make, for other what? Break. Bir tane on olacak ama diğer tane off olacak. Bu rolü zaten. Bak, şimdi su zaten şimdi on. Electricity verdiği zamanında magnetic field geldi. Sonra bu on olacak, diğeri off olacak. Make and break. Okay? Now, we have here some orange color stuff. It's shading coil. I think you don't know what is shading coil, right? It's used for preventing chattering. Chattering, it means it's chattering. So why we have chattering everywhere? This way. Do you know? No. Okay. What is the... I'm speaking about the voltage. If I'm using AC current with relay, I will have this signal, right? Okay. This signal will be applied here. It means I will have magnet field, magnet field, magnet field, then no magnet field, right? Here, no magnet field. Why? Because it's zero. Again, magnet field, magnet field, magnet field. Again, here what we have? Zero. So it means no magnet field, and so on. Every zero we have, we will not have any magnet field. Bu sinyal zaten sıfır geldiği zaman da manyetik, yani bu alan hepsi gider. Neden? Çünkü sıfır oldu. Evet. O zaman, bu nasıl olacak? How will it happen? On, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. It will be like this. This is called chattering. And this is very dangerous. Very dangerous. Why? Because with this movement, you will have some arc. Then it will weld. Maybe it will have also some, not explosion, but it will have some big trouble here. Maybe welding problem. So it will be connected together always. Okay? So lehim gibi olacak. Çünkü on off, on off. Ve sonra bir şu arc olacak. Sonra bu lehim gibi oluyor. Sonra her zaman buraya kalıyor. So how we can prevent this chattering? We can use this shading coil. It's very easy. It's very easy. It's based on giving a delay time. It give a delay time in order not to have this chattering. Only delay. So when I reach to here, I will have delay. So I will have magnet. Again, when it's come here, the delay will finish. Again, delay here, delay here, delay here, and delay and so on. So this is the explanation of the shading coil. Only if I have AC current. If I have DC, we don't have any problem. But only with AC currents, relays. Okay. Let's go to symbol. This is the symbol of copper pipe. I have normally open contact, normally closed contact, and I have here common. Okay. And I have coil. This is what one. This is the solenoid. The solenoid coil. If I give electricity, what will happen for this? On, what will happen for this? Off. So one of them will make and one of them will break. This is the relay. Okay, this is the relay type. Okay. This is the symbol. Let's go for next type, which is bridge. Bridge type. From the meaning of bridge, it means I'm not only clapping in this way. I'm just making a bridge shape. So here I have also another plunger, you can see. Inside here we have this shading coil, the red one, and that one is the bobbin. This is the bobbin. Again, when I give electricity, we have magnet field, and what will happen for plunger? It will go up, then look, it will become this way here. So it will make at the same time. Make. No magnet, break. Okay? So, you can see this is the symbol. We have coil and we have T1, L1, T2. So it will only connect these two. I don't have, for example, normally open, normally closed. Maybe for some type we have, but not all type. The normal branch type in this way. All of them normally open, or all of them normally closed. But usually, I mean, this is the way. Another information.
Hocam, evet. Özür diliyorum, bölüyorum da üzerinde herhangi bir şey yok şu anda. Görüntü, ses.
Görüntü, ses yok. Tamam, bakalım. Neden bu ya? Evet. Şimdi mi önce?
Hocam başından beri.
Neden kimse yazmıyor?
Hocam yazıyorlar da.
Yok, chat'taki bir şey yok.
Ben burada görüyorum, chat'te bayağı yazmışlar ama. Ha.
Durdurabilir misin?
Kırmızı oldu.
Okay, so this is the Klaho. Let's, I mean, some bridge. Let's explain again just for online students because maybe they didn't see. So it consists of plunger. It consists of plunger. Inside we have some bobbin. Then when we give the electricity to this bobbin, the plunger will move. Then those contact will make. If I have no electricity, it will break. And as you see here, we have shading coil in order to prevent the chattering. Okay. This is another example for bridge type. But look here, we have both type. We have all of them normally open and all of them normally closed. Also, we have those type of contact. And the symbol is like this. Okay. So just only one information I want to share that. The voltage which can bear by this bridge type is much more than the clapper type. Clapper type, let's say it can bear up to 24 voltage, 40 voltage, but that one it can reach maybe 200. Why? Because this is, I think, physical stuff. They divided the connection to two points. So the voltage, it will be break to two points. Because of that, I mean, it can bear more voltage. So this is, I think, some physical stuff. I'm not so professional in this, but I mean that is the reason. Let's go for type of relays. Okay. This is very, very important for us today. Type relays. But I mean, I will start with control relays, solid state relays, overload relays. Also, we will use too much. But this timing relay is also one of the important type of relay used in our PLC. Let's start with control relays. From control, it means I will control some circuit. Okay, this is the control relay. It's obtained in variety of styles and types. So, usually, as normal relay, it has normally open and normally closed contact. So when I give electricity, one of them will become on, one of them will become off. This is the type of control relay. It can be controlled by different type of voltage, maybe DC 12-24, maybe also AC 24 and 120, and so on. We have different type of control relays. Then, for this control relays, you know, I mean, I think most of you have trouble during the lehing, during welding. When we have IC put on the circuit, when we have transistor, when we have microcontroller, if you want to weld, if anything happens, what you will do? You should take off again. Is it easy? No. Usually what you do in order to make it easier for microcontroller, in order to take it off and bring it back again, what is the best way?
Port vardır hocam, 16'lık portu vardır.
Aha. Evet, sonra bu lehim yapıyor, sonra üzerine takıyoruz. Okay. So here same. We have what it called 11 pin or 9 pin sockets, this one. Here I install on my board, Then, depend if I have 11 pin or 8 pin, 11 or 8, I can put it over these sockets. Then, you can see here why we have this shape, it's not circle. Why we have this shape?
Yerine oturması için.
Yeah.
Oturması için tam olarak.
Mesela ters yaparsa, yani bu USB gibi, her şey gibi bir oturma yönü var. So, it should have some type of this security key in order to install the relays in the correct position. Because here, if you will take it in different way, the voltage for coil, it will be also opposite. So this is dangerous. Because of that, usually we put this safety guard or safety key. These two type of 11 pins and 8 pins, and this is the protection key. Look, here 2 and 10, and here 2 and 7 are the coil bobbin. This is a bobbin. Here you can give the electricity. Then what we will have? We have this normally 4 and 1 is normally closed. 5, 6 watt normally closed. 8 and 11 normally closed. When I give electricity, what will happen? All of them will be changed. So this will be off, this will be off, this will be off. Okay? Here, how about 8 and 6? What type of contact 8 and 6 here?
Normally open.
Normally open. 1 and 4. Normally closed. 2 and 7.
Coil.
What?
Coil.
Coil, yes. 2 and 7 is coil. This is not contact. Okay? This is the coil and this is the contact. And be careful, always as I told you. Previous week, I mean, I teach. The symbol of this is what? This is the symbol. What is this? This is coil. This coil symbol. And what are those? Let's say this is coil A, okay? Coil A. Okay? When I want to use those contacts in my circuit, what I should write here? I should write what? Etiquette label or label. So I should write here coil A. Coil A. And coil A. Right? But if I have another relay, like let's say I have coil B, okay? Okay. In this case, what is the name here? It will be coil B, coil B, and so on, and so on. So be careful. E, the label is very important. Coil A contact, it means it's related to this coil. Here, look. This is the contact for this coil, but this is the contact for another coil. Okay, so be careful for this. Okay, solid state. From the name of solid state, here we are not using mechanical movement. Here we are using the solid state material in order to make or break. So what I mean by solid state, like transistor, those material inside, NPN, PNP, and so on. One of famous type of those, triac and opto isolation. Both of them are used in order to control the output of the PLC. So here, when I ignite the triac or opto isolation, I can give order for the output circuit in order to connect motor, to connect, for example, some pressor, some pumping, anything. But here, do we have any mechanical movement? No, this is solid state. Those are solid state. Let me show you the picture. This is the triac, and this is also triac, most of them triac. But here, opto-isolation triac. Here, normal triac. So can you see here? Here is my coil. When I give electricity, the triac will be induced, then it will be on. So what will happen? I will connect my output circuit. Any mechanical? No, we don't have. Here solid state, total solid state. Here same, I give electricity, we have opto isolation. Here it will give light received by triac, then it will be on, then I can control my circuit. Hangisi daha güven? Which one is more safer?
Alttaki hocam o.
Neden?
Temas yok.
Temas yok. Because here we don't have any contact. If anything happens, this is burned or anything, what will happen? Only this will close. But here, if something burns, maybe it will affect. If this becomes, for example, straight, this is, will keep working, for example. So for me, I prefer this to use always, opto-isolation. It's more safe for the PLC. More safe for the PLC. Overload relays. These are the most important relay which is used with the motor. Why? Overload is different from shortcuts. Shortcuts, like, for example, if I have this socket, okay? This here. Okay, it has two pins, right? Two pins. If I connect it together, what will happen? You laugh. Why? If I connect together, patlıyor. Ya da bir sigorta varsa, so if we have fuse, what will happen? The fuse will off, will be off. This is different. Here, bu sigorta değil. This is not a municipal. This is overload relays. It means when the motor consume more than 115 or more than 125% of the current, in this case, the motor is working under very high load. Maybe one of the good example, kima makinesi, kimse var mı kima makinesi? Bu çiğ kofta yapmak için. Kima makinesi. Var mı?
Yok da biliyoruz.
Yok da var, herkes biliyor. Okay. Bu kima makinesi, yani eklediği zamanında tabii ki normal bir ses veriyor. Ama tabii ki bir kemik ekliyorsa ne olacak? Mesela böyle bir çok yani garip bir ses geliyor, sonra çıkıyor belki yani. Tabii ki yani makine böyle. So what happened here? Overload over the. You can feel that. Try to put some chicken inside this machine, because chicken is harder than meat. Usually you will feel that there is some sound. And the clever kima makinesi, clever one, usually it has overload relays. If anything happens, it will close. Suddenly it will close. Then how you can rerun again? There is some button. You can push this button, it will run again. You can check if you have kima makinesi, you can see this overload relays. Type. We have dual element type. We have thermal overload relays, and we have solid state or let's say magnetic overload relays. Let's go one by one. It's not difficult, this explanation. Let's go for picture. This is dual elements. Burası hem sigorta var mı hem overload var. İkisi birlikte. So these two of them, we have both of them. Look, we have here some solder here. In order if we have some overload. But also we have fuse element, this one. If anything happens, it will be cut. O zaman bu ikisi farklı neydi? Normalde belki şu yani sıcak boreye bu kesiltilecek.
Yüksek akımda.
Yüksek.
Yüksek akımda ısınıp kopar hocam.
Evet, yüksek akım ise bu yani gider. Ama shortcut varsa bu gider, hemen bu gider. Okay? Ya da bir ikisi birlikte gidiyor. İkisi birlikte gidiyor. Okay, let's go for this one. This is very interesting. It's very interesting. It's called thermal overload relay. It's not difficult. I will show you one video. Here connected to the motor, directly to the motor. Here, this is the motor. Then, inside here, this is overload relay. Here. Inside it has some type of chemical like mercury. Bu sıcak ölçüme bu eski kim bu sıvı ya sıvı
ya civa mı var
ne diyor civata
civa var ya içinde onun
evet bu madde normalde nasıl çalışıyor bu sıcak ile bu yani uzatıyor ya da bir şey olacak ama bu aynı mantık içerideki bir kimyasal bir madde var sıcak oluyorsa bu madde sıvı hale oluyor sonra bu tekerlek serbest olacak. Serbest o zaman hangi tarafa gidiyor? Serbest ise
aşağıda.
Aşağıda mı yukarıda?
Anlıyorum çocuğum.
Nasıl? Burası yay var.
Yukarı.
Yukarı. Neden yukarı? Bu basıyor. Burası bir yay var. Yay var için o zaman bu yukarı basıyor. Yani bu durum, yani orijinal haliye yani geri dönüyor. Bir video gösterelim, bir video gösterelim. Then we have another type, which is, you will see now. This is the overload type. Here, the motor will start to shake because it's overloaded. Because of that, I mean, we should have some type of protection. The protection is thermal overload. I will show you later about this thermal overload. This is overload relay. It's a bit big, I know. Look the function. Here is the loop. This is open type. When I push, look, it means the spring, it will be under stress here. This is the material. It's called eutectic alloy. It's kind of material, chemical one. A bit similar to this. When it's become hot, it become liquid. When it's become hot. So they put it inside this bar. When the motor is overloaded, here it's become hot for sure. Because look, the motor is connected to some type of fire. You will see now. This is the material. Here, buckle. It's connected to the motor, here and here motor. And when it's become hot, this buckle or copper, it will be also hot. Then this is will be melt, totally melted. Then here it will be free. So maybe this way will go or this way. Look now it's become liquid. And this will move free. This way or this way? Depends on your connection of the spring. But here, because this is under pressure, this will go up or down, for sure up, because the spring will push. Then, what will happen? How we can return this back? By hand. Tamamen kima makinesi gibi düşünebiliriz. So, if anything happens, you should push some button in order to return this back. This is the idea of thermal overload. And let's go to the slides again.
Hocam bir ara versek mi ya?
Ara? Olur. Sadece bu son magnetik göstereceğim sonra ara olur. Magnetik çok kısa zaten. Okay, so let's go for last one before the break. Here is overload, but here it's also different type of overload. It is based on magnetic overload, so it means here I'm using some solid state type. And this is another type of three-phase thermal overload relay, the one I showed you before, but this is for three phases. Let's have break, and then we can continue. Okay, after the break, let's continue with the type of the relay, which is time relay. I thought this is one of the important relay which I will use in the PLC. And we have two main types. Maybe previous week also I show you about the types. One of them I call on delay relay. The second one is off delay relay. Okay. This we can call it DOE. It means delay on energized. And that one is DODE dot. So is delay on de-energize. Delay on de-energize. So it means here in this timer, delay start after I give electricity. But here no, it will not start until I stop the electricity. Come on. I will explain here too much. And every year I have question about this, and always the student make mistake, I don't know why. And Sinan also extend many time, year of time, but because it's not difficult, but I don't know, the student keep make mistake in this. Very easy, but they are keep making mistake. Now, please concentrate, and also for online or NGR action. Okay. Now let's start. If I give energy, this is the time table of the energy, and here the contact energy. Now let me choose first type of contact, because look, depend on the contact, it will be changed. If I have normally open contacts, okay, normally open. And here, this is the energy. If I have energy here, what is the energy here?
Normal
zero
open,
off, right? Why? Because this is normal open. Okay? Then, if I give energy for the coil, so this is the coil, let's say the coil energy. Coil. This is coil energy. If I give energy, like this, okay? And then I stop it here, okay? What will happen from that? What will happen, do you think?
Kapanacak mı? Kapanacak.
Neden? On delay. On delay, it will start counting after energize. It means, when I have energy, it start to count. It means, look, it will start to count. It will start to come up to certain level, which is this one is delay. This is the delay. Okay? For one more. Okay. After this delay, what will happen? Again, this is will change here, this way. And up to which level? Up to here. When I have no energy, so it will become. Did you understand the idea? I give the energy for the timer coil because this is on delay. O zaman şu on delay ne zaman sayma başlıyor? Enerji verdikten sonra. Verdikten sonra sayma başlıyor. O zaman burası sayma başlıyor. Bir şey yani değişmiyor. Sonra yani gecikme olduktan sonra tabii ki bunun durum değişir. O zaman off ise on olacak, on ise off olacak. Sonra sürekli devam ediyor bu enerjiyle. Sonra enerji kestiği zamanında tabii ki bu hemen değişiyor, hemen. Çünkü sadece timer ne zaman? Bu zamanda timer var. Burası timer yok. Evet. Şimdi off delay bak. Let's go for off delay. This is the coil. Coil. And here is the contact. Normally open. Şimdi off delay hakkında başlayacağım. Off delay. Off delay. Off delay. This is off delay. When I have no energy, then I have energy, then I stop energy. Okay? Here, what is the definition? Delay on de-energize. O zaman gecikme ne zamandan başlıyor? Kestikten sonra. On de- o zaman buradan bir şey başlıyor mu? Yok. O zaman bu nasıl olacak? Now it will be here, then directly it will be up, so it will be on, then up to this level, here, then...
Gidecek hocam, birazcık daha açık
olacak. So it will be continue, it will be continue, then up to here, and then this way. So from here to here, let's say from here to here, here is my delay. Okay, this is my delay. Gecikme ne zamandan başladı? Enerjiyi kestikten sonra başlıyor. Yani enerjiyi kestikten sonra sayma başlıyor. O zaman bu durum on ise on devam ediyor. Off ise off devam ediyor. Sonra ne zaman kesiliyor sonra? Tabii ki bu gecikme kısadıktan sonra. Kısadıktan sonra bu hemen off olacak. Ama tabii ki bu hangi örnekler için? İkisi normally open. So those two examples are for normally open. But in the exam we have many cases. We have many cases. For example, if I have for normally close. Okay? Okay? Let's go. For normally close, no energy, energy, no energy. Okay. What is the first case for this? Energy. Yes. It will be energy. Then
delay. Yeah.
Delay. Delay. Because what? Delay on energize. Buf, ilk durum neydi? The first situation was on. Because this is normally closed. On. So when we have energy here,
still on.
We will start. Start timing. Burada sayma başlıyor. O zaman sayma başlıyor. Bak. Başladı. Sonra belli bir zamanda, so here, after a delay time, what will happen? It will be off. Then, look here. Oraya cevap sen her zaman yanlış yapıyor. Neden on oldu?
Enerji bitti.
Enerji kestiği için bu tekrar yani ilk hale geri döndü. Okay? Çünkü bu ilk hale çok önemli burası. Burası on ise tekrar on olacak. So that one is delay. That one is delay. Okay? Let's go for off. For off delay. Normally close, and here is coil. Now I give energy, and then I stop. Okay. Bu ilk durum neydi? First situation what?
Close.
On. Here. On. Then
off.
Why off? Bu ne zaman başlıyor? Enerji kestikten sonra. Burası ben enerji verdim. O yüzden bu hemen yani değişiyor. Hemen değişiyor. Tamam. Sonra enerji nerede ben kestim? Burası kestim. O zaman şimdi başladı. Şimdi başladı. Bu noktadan dile başladı. Ne kadar bilmem yani bir belli bir zaman. Şöyle. Sonra şöyle. Sonra şöyle. O zaman delay bu delay. Okay. Tabii ki sınavdaki ihtimaller bayağı var. Mesela bu enerji şöyle olabilir. Ya da mesela şöyle şöyle şöyle şöyle olabilir. Yani ihtimaller bayağı var sınavda. Ben her sınav, her sene bir soru çıkacak burada. Bu sene de var. Ama tabii ki yani farklı geçecekler. zor değil, çok kolay ama bilmem yani öğrenciler her zaman mantık olarak karıştırıyor. Çok kolay. Burası enerji verdikten sonra saymaya başlıyor. Burası kestikten sonra sayma başlıyor. Başka bir şey. Delay on energized. Delay on de-energized. On de-energized. Any question? Online öğrencilerin soru var mı? Başka bir soru var mı? Can I continue?
Yes.
Okay. For the timing relays, as I told you, we have some symbols. On delay, I have arrow inside. This is arrow. This is on delay. But off delay, arrow is outside. Be careful in exam if you put different, I cannot understand. I mean, depend on your circuit. Yani senin devre göre ben takip ediyorum. Yani istersen bu kadar bilsin, bu kadar bilsin. Ama ben bu mantık göre takip edeceğim. Bazı önce mesela bu kullanıyor ama onun aklında bu yani düşünüyor. So be careful if you want to use on delay. This is on delay. Off delay is this off delay. Şimdi yeni olan, we have some new type. Which is on-off delay. This is in some PLC. How?
İkisinde de delay var.
Enerji verdiği zaman da sayma başlıyor. Ve kestiği zaman da o da sayma başlıyor. İkisi birlikte. Böyle bir çeşit o da var. Ama tabii ki bu yeni bir çeşit. Bu temel çeşitler. No? We can use also those type, which is not switches. It's contact. If I write TC, it means on delay because it's timing closing contact. TO it's time opening contact. This is mean off delay. This is on delay. This is off delay type. Depend on what you write here, I can understand. In exam, you can also use those. It's based on you. This or this in the exam. It's up to you. Okay. Let's go for another type of time relay. Here, it's not using the electrical stuff. Here, I'm using some pneumatic system. Very interesting. Very interesting this one. I like it. Eski piyano biliyor musun bu? Şöyle hareket yapıyor. Neydi bu isim?
Akordeon.
Akordeon. So, usually, how we can give the sound for this piano? Usually by air, right? By air. It has some bellows. This is an accordion, this is an bellows. Here I have spring, and here the timer. Here I can adjust, then I can control the air, How it work? Look, if I push this, here, what will happen? The air will go out, okay? And this is will be on. Okay? Then, this after I push. If I release, this one, this is go back. And this will go back because of the spring. But it will go slowly. Why slowly? Because it should have air. Okay? The air will enter, then this will move, and then it will reach here, will be off. So this is also type of timer, timer relays. Any question for this type? Did you understand or not too much? It's only type of bellow. When you push, air go out directly, and this on. When you release, bırakıyorsa, bu tabii ki yavaş yavaş bir şekilde hareket ediyor. Neden? Çünkü hava giriyor yavaş yavaş bir şekilde. Buna göre hava gidiyor. Tabii ki bu çok açık ise hava çok gidiyor. Ama çok yani dar ise hava yani yavaş yavaş bir şekilde giriyor. Sonra şöyle şöyle şöyle yavaş yavaş. Sonra buraya geldiği zaman da bu açacak. Sonra yani delay gibi oluyor. Delay gibi mana oluyor. Those are another, I mean, famous type. This is old time with analog. You can adjust the timer. It consists of motor inside, AC motor. And it's learning like, I mean, our clock. Do we have clock here? Yes. It's similar a bit to that one. Very similar. Here, new type is based on solid state material. You can adjust using some electronic buttons. Any question for time relays? Any question for time relays? Okay, if you don't have any question, let's go for last type of relays before I go to conductor. It's phase fader relay. I don't know if I show you before. I think I show you the. Did you remember this shape? Previous week. Three-phase power circuit. It has contact and overload relay plus motor. Here phase number one, phase number two, and phase number three. Okay. Yani gelecek haftalardaki yani gösterecem. Bizden sonra zannediyorum. Normalde motor yön değişmek için iki faz değişirse yeter. Ya da bir faz giderse ne olacak? Mesela bu üç faz ile çalışıyor. Bir faz giderse motor sürekli yani devam ediyor. Ama şimdi amper çok alıyor. Yani akım çok alıyor. O çok tehlikeli bir şey. O yüzden biz bu kullanıyoruz. So this is type of relay. It can detect the missing phase. Missing phase. If one of them missed suddenly, for any reason, this will directly stop the motor work. This is the phase failure relays. Any question for this? Any question? Let's go for contactors. What do you think is the difference between relays and contactors? What do you think? Do you know a contactor before? Did you see? No. Okay. Actually, contactor and relays are exactly same. Electromechanical devices. Same. We have bobbin, we have plunger, we have everything. But difference here, we can control high voltage with contactor. With relays, we can control low voltage. So those are designed for high voltage, high power. It can reach to sometimes 1 megavolt, 1 kilovolt. But more or less, I mean the famous one, contactor coil voltage which is 24 to 600. But this is, look, this is a coil. This is the coil voltage, not the control voltage. Coil voltage, it's not important to be very high. But the control voltage is very high. Yeah, bu bobinin voltage. Ama tabii ki yani çıkış yani benim için normalde tabii ki yüksek bir voltaj gider. 1 mega yani bazen şu yani 1000 kilo yani istediğin gibi gidebilir. Okay. Relay is bobbin voltage is 5 to 100 volt, but this is only for bobbin, the bobbin voltage. But also because this is can control very high voltage, the bobbin should be also strong, not even like this. Now, always put in your brain, when you are working with low voltage, for example, this 5 volt, our transistor, microcontroller, all of those are very easy to control because it's low voltage, 5 volt, 12 volt, 24 maximum, maybe, okay? But when we deal with very high voltage, 1 mega, 100 mega, this actually dangerous. So, high voltage control will give some problem, and also low voltage control will give problem. Okay, what I mean by high voltage contact control, now I'm mentioning here the bobin. Bu bobinin voltage. Bu çok yüksek birerse ne olacak? Ve çok düşük birerse ne olacak? Okay? When I give high voltage, very high voltage to the bobin, only to bobin, what will happen? You know, this is electromechanical device, so there is magnet. When I give very high voltage, the magnet will directly go up, okay? It means the contact, if it's this way, it will directly, I mean, touch. But it will touch in very strong way. If it's touching in very strong way, it means I will have slam problem. It's like hammer, okay? Why? Because I give very high voltage to the bobbin here. I give to this bobbin high voltage for maybe, let's say, 1000. So it will not go normally this way. It will go very strong. So this touching, by time, 1, 2, 3, maybe 100 times, what will happen here?
Delik, böyle bir şey.
Delik aşınma. Ya da aşınma. Yani her şey olabilir, olacak, olacak. Başka bir problem. Basketbol biliyor musun? When I bounce my basketball, I just push like this. What will happen? It will go and then come back again. This is same. When I'm pushing, it will not only I stop here. No, this is very strong. This is high voltage. It will go and then go back, go back, go back until it's reached. So what is this? Is bones? Bones problem like basketball. Okay. This, I mean, this way of movement, what will happen?
Arc.
What will happen then? Welding, and then it will stop. If it stop it, how I can go up, back? I cannot, so we will die. This is, I mean, very dangerous. So be careful, this is another problem, which is bones. And slam problem, plus overheat, because I'm giving very high voltage. Maybe the bobbin will be hot and also it will be melted. This is high voltage problem of the contact. But also if I give low voltage to the bobbin, also it's dangerous. Don't think only high voltage is dangerous. Always when we are dealing with high voltage component, both are dangerous. High voltage dangerous, low voltage dangerous. But for motor, small motor, high, small, it's not so much big difference, but here is big difference. For low voltage, what will happen for low voltage? Let's say, bizim yani bobin 24 volt ile çalışır, tamam? Ben 20 volt verdim. O zaman evet, manyetik yani alan var. Ama nasıl? Şöyle çok yavaş gidiyor. Bazen belki şöyle temas yapıyor, şöyle böyle bir temas. Yani çok yavaş bir şekilde temas. Hatta bazen voltaj yetişmezse bazen böyle oluyor. Ama nasıl devam edebilir? Devam edebilir. Neden? Çünkü arc var. Bu arc varsa bu zaten temas gibi. Ama şöyle bir arc sürekli varsa ne olacak? Bu arc tekrar lehim gibi sonra şöyle oluyor. Yapıştırma yapıyor. So this is also low voltage problem. It can cause an arcing and possible welding of the contacts. So this is a bit careful. Another, I mean, the armature may pick up, but not completely seal. Also, I explain this one. Again, the stationary core. This can cause an air gap between four pieces. So it means this is the air gap, okay? And this preventing the coil current from dropping to its seal core value. So it means, I mean, we cannot reach to our, I mean, appropriate current for this. So those are two problems for the low voltage supply of the bobbin. Any question? Any question for those? Any question? Let me just drink water. Now let's go for type. We have load conductors. It can, I mean, be large actually, and can reach up to 100 amperes. We have vacuum type. Vacuum, it means I put my contacts inside, let's say, a cabin with no air totally. And we have mechanically held contacts. I will show you later. Yes, I can explain. Load contacts. Load contact, it means I'm controlling very high voltage. High voltage, it means I will have problem of stopping the contact. Okay, because it's high voltage. Sadece on yapma zor değil. Hatta şu off yaptığı zaman da o da zorlanıyor. Çünkü bu yani yüksek voltaja ile çalışıyor. Yani on yaptığı zaman da bir problem olacak. Off yaptığı zaman o da başka bir problem olacak. Hangi problem? Arc. Çünkü şimdi on şöyle, tamam? Bir problem yok. Temas tamamen var. Off yaptığı zaman da ben tabii ki manuel bir şekilde yapabilirim. Ya da otomatik. Bu yaptığı zaman da bu çok yüksek volt için şöyle oluyor. Sonra bu yüksek volt olduğu için kesinlikle arc olacak. Sonra çok yani uzatıyorsa tabii ki bu arc gider. Ama bu arc sürekli varsa tekrar hani bu lehim bir problem olacak. Nasıl bu arc hemen kestirebiliriz? Böyle bir teknik var. Arc chamber. We can put arc inside a chamber, small a room. We have arc chutes and blow out board. I will show both of you. Here is arc chutes. Look, this is the, let's say, the contactor. I here. If I want to go normal way, I will go this way, okay? But if I have design like this, when I go back, the arc will go here, it will become, look, from here, then it will be stopped. So it means I change the length of the arc. If this is straight, this way it will be from here to here, but this way hopefully, but if I have this shape, it will be very long. For this long, it means I can stop arc in short time, not like I mean normal design. This is it called arc chutes. But the best type is this blue out coil. Here. What I do, I have coil here. I connect it to my motor. I mean, this is actually the motor. Connect it to this coil, and this is permanent magnet. What will happen? When I open, arc will start here, right? Because we have here magnet, it will take it up. Like a vacuum, it will take it up directly, it will be removed. So here, it's better way than previous one. But you can use both. You can use here this shape plus blue out together. This is the blue out. This is the load contact. I think I show you this before. This is the power circuit and this is control circuit. Random, I will not extend the circuit. But I want to show you the load contact. This is load contact. Control contact goes. This is the control contact. Okay. So for our contactor, if we want to control motor, usually we use those. Those contacts we use it for our motors. Nothing I mean here. Let's go for next. A bit sıcak burası. Neden?
Bilmez mi?
Otomatik mi?
Kapalı
açık değil ya. Let's go for this type. It's vacuum conductor. You can see this is only a section of it. Here we have contactor, but it's inside non-air cabin. It's non-air. So it means when we have no air, it means no arc. So actually this is good that we will have no arc when I start or stop. When I have start or stop and we don't have any arc here. And I like the thing here because it's inside a non-air cabin. We can design in smaller way. I don't need to make it big. But previous one, because I mean it's different than this control really. Usually it's come big, but that one we can make it compact a bit. This one. Another type is this. I like it too much. It's very nice for control. It's mechanically held contactors. Normalde, ben enerji verdiği zamanında normalde kontakt ya on ya off olacak. Tamam. Burası aynı mantık. Here, when I give electricity to this latch coil, what will happen? The contact will close. Okay? Then, normal röledeki nasıl bu geri dönebilir? How we can make it off again? Just I remove electricity from here, right? Should be. So it means this is my coil. Okay? If I give electricity, what will happen for here? What will happen? If I give electricity, this will be on. But if I have no electricity, what will happen? This off. But that one different. That's one difference. If I want to make it on, I should energize this. If I want to make this off, I should energize this. Burası iki bobinler var. Bir kontaktör yani kapatmak için, diğeri kontakt yani açmak için. Yani sadece elektrisini kestiği zaman da bu bir şey değişmez. Bu kontakt kapatmak için, bu açılmak için. Tamam? So, let me show you one shape here. Can you see here we have two switches. One of them on, one of them off. On related to latching, it means lay latching. You unlatching. Bu bastığı zamanında hangisi çalışacak? Bu kontaktör. O zaman bu on olacak. Sonra yani load'lar çalışacak. Evet. Şimdi ben on bastım. Bırakıyorsam
devam ediyor.
O zaman burası başka bir mühürleme tekniği gerekiyor. Evet. Nasıl ben durdurabilirim bu ikisi? Bu unlatching mobile bir enerji verecek. Enerji veriyorsam bu off olacak. Sonra motorlar ya da load'lar biraz tekrar ara vereceğim. Sonra bu başlayacak. Tamam? So let's start the after break. Another, I mean, 10 slides, I think, almost if you finish. Motor starter. Motor starter is not something so much invention. It's actually only contactor with additional overload. When I have contactor plus overload, it become motor starter. Not so much difficult. Usually we can measure the power of this contactor using this equation. P equal to E multiply I. As much as we have high voltage, as much as we can make it smaller. Why? Because if the voltage is very high, the ampere will be very low for the same power. It means I can design this to be small. So this is motor starter, not so much difficult. Those are some shape of this motor starter. I don't know if you can see exactly, but here we have the face. Here we can supply the voltage. Here I have some auxiliary contacts. And we have some overload relay, but I cannot see because of the light. You can see on the slide more clearly. So this is the motor starter, the very simple control system. This is power control system. Can you show me where is contactor?
Start'ın altında mı hocam?
Contactor hangisi?
Soldaki yani.
Tabii. Bu contactor. Contactor'ın bobin nerede?
Aşağıdaki, sağdaki.
Sağ, şu mu?
Yok, sağdaki.
Okay. This is the coil can control this. Plus auxiliary contact nerede?
Start'ın altında.
And where is overload release?
şeyde, OLHP'de.
This.
Yok this. Hocam, yukarıdakilerde.
Plus this. For both of them. We have here and we have here. Over road relay and we have here over load relay. So, let's go for control transformer. This is also will be very important. Control transformer we can control using two type. We can go for control of 240 volt or 480 volt. For same transformer, we can control one of them. How we can do that is only the way of connection. Actually, I have two coil. Either I connect serial or I connect parallel. If I connect serial, which one do you think I can control? If I connect it serial, which one do you think? This or this? Hangisi? Yok. Dört yüz sekiz. For serial, we can control high voltage, but for parallel, we can control low voltage but high ampere. For sure, for high ampere. So those two, same transformer, but different connection. Now, how we can design our transformer to have parallel serial? Look at this design. This is primary and this is secondary. Okay. Why they put it this in this way? Why they are not putting here and here? It's not easier. Why? It's not stupid to make it cross this way. It's easy for me to put it this way and finish. But actually, there is some reason. Do you know why? No? Okay. Let's see. For parallel, H2, H3, H2, H4. Okay? H also, H1, H3, H2, H4. For serial, H1, H2, and then H2, H3, H3, and H4. Okay? Let's go. Now, how I can make this serial? Serial. H1.
H2. H2'dan H3'yi.
Then?
Sonra H3'den.
So it means, where is my connection?
H2 ile H3'ye.
Here, right? Okay. Parallel. H1, H3 and H2, H4. H1, H3 and H2, H4. So it means I can connect this way. Imagine if I make this straight, it will be so much messy. Look, this is very clever design in order to have parallel. This is parallel plus to have serial type of transformer. Because of that, they have this kind of cross function. Okay, so for transformer, usually we calculate the power not using watt, we are using volt ampere. What I mean by volt ampere? Because actually volt ampere and watt is same, because what is volt multiply ampere. Why transformer use this volt ampere? Because the transformer give you power. But for motor, it's consume power. If it's consuming power, I can say it's watt. If it's giving power, I can go for volt ampere. So what is this equation here I've been giving? This is the maximum ampere of output of transformer. So here is the power of transformer. This is voltage of secondary. And here the maximum ampere of secondary winding. I can give you one example. Where is the example? Here, it's written here 250 VA, it's volt ampere. And if I want, this example, if I want output 120, if I want. So I divide this by this, and I will have the maximum output ampere, it will be 2 ampere, 2.08 ampere. And what else? let's go for last two slides and I finish my lecture today. Here, grounding and floating control system. You will see this in my lecture later on. What is this? Power circuit. And this is control circuit. What is difference between this and this? Here I write floating and here I write grounding. What is difference? Is it same? Fark neydi?
Burada bir ground var hocam.
Nerede? Burası mı?
Yok, sağda şimdi.
Bu. Evet. Okay. So here we have ground, here I don't have ground. If I have a ground on this output of transformer, because this is transformer, I call it grounded system. But if we don't have, it means floating system. Now, another question. Here I have avometer. I'm connecting here and to ground and here to ground. Which one correct and which one is not correct?
Sağdaki correct.
Neden?
Çünkü groundlar aynı.
Ama bu?
Farklı.
Bir şey veriyor burası.
Verir ama yani ne verir?
Okay, so actually the left side is not correct and right side is correct. For floating, usually we should use this system in order to measure the voltage between the robot motor and the transformer because it's floating system. So I can say this is correct and that one is not correct. Any question? I'm sorry today it's a bit long, but you know I mean alphabet, then word. Then next week we will start with sentences on the PLC. Any question for lecture number two? Thank you for listening, thank you for attending and see you next week.